Happy Mother's Day, everyone. Well, being a mother now for 13 years, I'm still can't believe I am a mother. Because when you were younger, you thought, I'll have all the time for that. I'll probably have my babies when I'm in my 30s or so and have everything in place and everything will be hunky-dory. Well, it's usually the opposite. But I am totally, totally grateful for being a mother and having the support of my husband and actually, he really blamed me. If it wasn't for his upbringing and even my mother, because she has always talked to me. If it wasn't education, it was about how to raise your children, how to act in public and such. And so we're at that point now where we have a 10-year-old and a 13. Everybody say, "Oh, you're in those teenage years now." I say, "Yeah, we're just getting started." And so they are a joy. But you know, our schedules are hectic. You know, we're not here at church. We're at football. We're at basketball. What else? Justice has other extracurricular tracks. See, I can't keep track of them all. He's honor society stuff. And so, you know, it is a juggle. How do you keep your strength, you ask? That is being grounded in the Word, being faithful, and being committed to the Word personally, have a personal relationship with God. Spend the reading time. Pastor Hill encourages us to have 15 minutes of praying in the Spirit. I've been doing that. Derek asked me that actually this morning. He said, "Have you been praying in the Spirit?" Yeah, I've only been taking care of business. I've been doing that probably for a year or so, being committed to that. And even this year, I've been on track about, I made my own personal commitment to read the Bible daily. And so that's keeping me grounded, and I work 40 plus hours. And now my schedule the last 2 months, I've traveled to Bartlesville and back. And I enjoy what I'm doing. And so when you enjoy what you're doing, it is not gruesome, it's not tiresome. Yeah, there are times you do get tired. And get weary, but again, when you have the support of your mother and your father and your husband and close friends, and you might not have a lot of friends when you have a family and a hectic schedule, and you have your few good friends that you keep in contact with. That again, we tell our children, you're not gonna always have a whole school of friends. Have your select few, because those few are the ones that they're there with you when you have, and they're there with you when you don't have. And that's the definition of a true friend. And so, again, without the ministry and the encouragement and the word that goes forth here, I thank you for the ministry, Pastor and Sister Hill, my own mother, for doing what she has done. She's always been a hard worker, and I've always seen that. I know that's where I get it from. And Derek said it's just because you have to make it. You know, people work 2 and 3 jobs because they have to make. You just a workhorse. You just a brama bull. You can just do it all. I'm like, I try to do it all. There are times I get weary, but I know my relationship is with the Lord. He keeps me going, and without Him, I would not be anything. So I thank you.
Amen. We appreciate you so very much. Came from different perspectives, yet we see the challenges. And those of us who have already reared our children, they are grown and gone, we know that it is true that it takes a village. You cannot do this alone. It takes mothers, fathers, grandparents, our aunts, uncles, relatives, you name it. It does take a village for this awesome task. And that and then some.